Come on, Leo, quick. Right, I'm gonna set the rules. Set the rules before the fight starts. Yeah? The rules has got to be obeyed. The rules is broke, whoever breaks the rules lost. And that's the way the fight goes.
It is a lovely thing to see when two men has got a problem. It just gives you a bit more confidence that there is proper men out there still. They'll have a fair fight and sort out like men.
Right, John, I'm setting the rules before the fight starts, so I'll tell you fair play, right? Hang on a second. No kicking, no biting, boys, no headbutt. It's a fair fight. Whoever breaks the rules first, lost. And that goes for the suing, right? You shake hands afterwards. Best man win. Let's keep it fight nice and clean now, boys. Well, them up. You all right?
Well, it's in your heart, it's in your mind, it's in your family, it's in the blood. And that's it. The only one thing we know how to do, when we get disrespected, the only thing we know how to do is fight.
Let him up, stand back, let him up. Fair play.
It's like a disease. It's like a disease that gets in your blood. And sometimes you close your eyes out, oh, just wish I wasn't like it. But you can't help it.
I want to be a fighter like me, Daddy.
And why do you want to be a fighter?
Because I'm reared up with fighters.
If he, like, fights, he'll get badder and badder and he might die.
Hello, I'm coming across and I'm going to beat the shit out of him today. All I want is a fight.
This is our life. This is our way. Other people, you always see other people's life. It was their way. This is our way.
I'll kill him, man.
A fair fight, not a dirty fight. Like a clean, fair fight. No biting, no pinching, like a girl. No written hair. Just want a fair fight. And that's all you know.
My Francie, he loves boxing. You know, he loves fighting. He'd fight all day.
True traveling men, true fighters.
But that's the same with all the little children. They all try to be good in front of their father and impress them and do things. It's a big responsibility to have the name Doherty, because automatically when you're born with that name Doherty, you're branded. You got to try and stick to your morals and your ways that you've been brought up with, that your father and your uncles has had and their fathers, and it's been on for hundreds of years.
When I'm in a fight, I have to remember it's not just for me, it's for my family and my name.
What would I do if you lost, Francie?
Drown.
I'd drown him, you reckon, see? That's just the way you're brought up, and then when he's a man, that'll be his motto in life, that he can't lose. He just can't lose, as simple as.
So you're saying you'd drown your own
Well, it's a hard thing to say. You'd actually really would drown your son. But, like, in fairness, I couldn't. I'd rather kill myself than drown my son, obviously. But what I mean is, it's one of these things. It's a thing that you have to think to yourself. It's a thing you have to get in your head. And it's a thing that from that age, they've got to have it in their head. They've got to put it in their head that they can't lose. And that's how serious it is if you lost.
That's it, eh? Let's see how young of an age they can learn. Because it's in their blood. All travelling children is the same. This little travelling boys of any age can box. It's tries anyway. Come on. One, two, go on. Bing, bang.
So that's your youngest son?
That's my youngest son, yeah. He's 18 months. He's a strong, tanky little bilf.
I love him.
He's done you a couple of times, hasn't he, Francie, with his teeth?
Yeah.
Go on and box. He wants to do it again. He wants another round. Box. See, he won't give. Go on, Charlie. Uppercut, Charlie. Front uppercut, Charlie. Up the way, quick. Over the top, hook. Push, bosh. Bing, bang. It's the way you're bred. You're bred to fight. You're gonna fight. You don't think of the consequences. You just want to do it. When you're in a fight, you completely change into a different person. You know, you come from being the nice guy that gets on with everyone and, you know, into a very, very mad, aggressive person in a fight. It's been a man. I was born a man, and I'll die a man. I would rather die on my feet than live on my knees for any man in the world. There's no man in the whole world will talk about me, backbite me, and get away with it if I find out.
Fred, you come for you in your dreams. He's a raving lunatic, and he's not a man to be messed about with.
If you hit him, you upset him. I don't think you'll hurt him, you'll just actually upset him.
What are you up to, Fred?
Well, we're just getting prepared, Leo, to go move home for the... winter. We had a nice summer away, it's been enjoyable. It's a bit of an experience again this year. And we got a few quid. Now we're off home, spend it. Misses to make short work of it.
How are you going to spend your money?
Down the pub. See, it might be an old trailer, boys, but this is all I got. See, my castle, this is my castle. Do you know what I mean? So men say that home is the castle. This is my castle.
Travelling life to me is everything. I don't think I'll ever settle down. I've been in a lot of places and met a lot of people and working on the way, and it's all good experience for the kids. And in the winter time, we go back home, we settle in for the winter and put the kids in school so they get their education. And they look forward to when the springtime gets here. It's where we're going this year, there. It's where we're off.
Oh, yeah?
When I talk to people, I want to be known as a gentleman, someone like my father was. I don't want to be known as a fighter. I don't want to be known as, oh, that guy, don't go near him because he lit you.
Sponging down for a strike there. How's that? If I don't want my sons, try not to get them into fighting. They'll be boxers. They'll be holding their hands up. I train them myself when they get a bit older, but I don't really want them to be fighters. I don't want them to be fighting all the time, like I did.
Do you think they will be?
I think they will, yeah. Well, the youngest one, he's a bit of a character, and the other one, I don't know. I'm not going to encourage it, put it that way.
The shoe, you little cunt. What are you doing that for? That's your daddy's good work shoe.
What do you think about going back to school?
I don't like it.
Why don't you like it?
Because teachers get you told off and I don't like it.
But you keep getting in trouble?
Yep.
Frank Howell's completely opposite to his dad. He's completely, he don't like rowing and fighting. He'd rather sit and play on his DS or play around the camp or what. He don't like coursing matches and he don't like chicken fights. And He don't like things like that. And that's that. I don't think Fred would like him to fight. Or Cash. But Cash is like his dad.
You're dead!
Show me it down. Oh, my God. What a shot. Who wants to drive? I thought you was going to say that. Cash driving on the road. Faster. Whoa, Cash, baby.
I just come from Malden. I drove into Yolden. The turbo was lively that night. In walked young Stevie, Reuben and Levy, and somebody wanted to fight. When the drinks finally hit 'em, said Levy, let's get 'em, and they made a mad dash across the floor. The chairs started flying, and the chairs were crying.
It's not very nice laying in your bed sometimes. I don't know if your husband's coming home, or if he's going to be killed, or something's going to happen, or he's going to do something.
Four big red faces.
And when Fred loses his temper, he ain't normal. He just goes off of it, goes mad. He's just frightening.
At 2 a.m, down at the station, they all staggered in one by one.
We don't take each other to court. We don't sue each other. If we got a problem with each other, we go out and fight.
And Levy was holding her gun. At 4 a.m, the old sergeant was yawning when the final statement was read. With tears in his eyes from hearing such lies, he rapped on the desk and he said,
"What's it like to be back home, Fred?"
Feels good, man, feels good.
That one's called Blackie.
And what kind of dog is he?
Jack Russell Terrier.
What does your dad think of Blackie?
He likes him a bit, but sometimes he kicks him because he sticks up for me. I've got another dog.
What do you mean he sticks up for you and your dad kicks him? What do you mean?
Like, if my dad's trying to smack me, it starts biting. And then me dad kicks it away.
This is my own town, chicken fights, coursing, fights when we get drunk in the pub, can't get a better. This is the best place to stop in the world. Peck him then, my boy, peck him, that's it. Hold on it. Kill him, then, you fucking useless cunt. He's gone. Finish him, son, finish him.
Drown her on her nose.
Oh.
Rub her down.
Oh, God.
Good girl. Talk, I think.
Oh, God.
Good girl.
Oh, God. He's got nice little big hooves, that what we like in horses. He's got a little tick tail. Mane. When he's grown up, you can just tell. When he's grown up, his hair is sweeping the ground. She's heavy. Very heavy. There.
She's starting to come grey now as well, look.
Yeah.
My son now, he goes to school and education now has come very important to him because of the way, obviously, laws and things has changed in the country. And most travelling kids anyway do know about horses, and it's very, very important to know enough about them not to be caught, for instance, if they're buying one, to give too much money for it, or if they're selling one, not to get enough for it. And that it's nice to see your sons to grow up and do the things that you've done and what your father have done, your grandfather, and going back in generations, for what all your people have done all their life.
So you're Francie's uncle?
Yeah, he's my uncle. I'm his uncle, and he knows if he's a bit cheeky, he'll get a nice little black eye, won't you, Francie? Yeah, come on now, man.
What's Francie like? Tell me about
him. He's a bit annoying sometimes, because he calls me really bad names. But
fat, I like fatty.
You know, but he knows he'll get a really bad beating then.
He chases me all around the site.
I chases him everywhere. Then I grabs a cane stick and I bait it off him. I breaks him off the top of his brains right there. And as you can see, look, that's what I done last week to him. I've got to give him a bit of a wedgie.
Let me do that. Now that he's done it. Oh, good job. Hello, Fanny.
Listen, fools out there thinking yourself all the biggie. But who's the man I am?
Come on, Fatty.
To see it?
No!
Why not?
Because I'm not a pervert.
Teaching you give him, the stronger his morals and his pride he'll get. If I ever seen my son, for instance, and someone talked to him like he was a fool or like talked over him, and if I didn't see him stand up for himself, you know, the first thing I'd do is I'd probably hit my son, and then I'd hit the fella who talked like that to him. I don't care if I was 70. And if I seen him even sparring or fighting another little boy, if I seen him running away or if I seen him jacking or crying, then I would beat him, which thank God he's never done it. But I would. I would give him a good checking and a good slapping. I'd explain to him that he can't do that. You know, you gotta stand up, you gotta fight till you die if you have to. You pump it into his head to be a man, fight, but don't ever jack, don't believe in it. Then he won't.
Every little travelling boy, when they grow up, someone is gonna pick on him, someone will be on his case, and he's gonna have to fight. So,
is that why you prepare him?
I don't prepare him to go out and fight and put his head down. I always tell my
children grown up, please don't get into trouble on your older, stay out of trouble. Just don't ever let nobody
push you around.
Push you around. You know, don't let nobody walk on you. Don't let nobody insult you. You know, and be ignorant to you. Stand up for yourself. You know what I mean? Go out and fight if you have to fight, but avoid it.
My oldest boy, he's more of an intelligent kid than when he's a fighter, and I don't really want him to fight. I don't want my kid to fight. Otherwise, why do you want your kid to fight, go through pain that I've been through? He was 18 months old, and he was my first kid, and he never left his shoulder. He learned to talk and everything, and started to say mum and dad, and he was starting to say things. And then I went to prison. When I went to prison, he was devastated. My son was devastated because I went to prison for fighting. He didn't know what I was for. And I come out 2.5 years later, and he lost his speech. He couldn't talk. He didn't understand why someone took his dad away from him.
Told you.
First blood.
Did you get me the first shot?
Just shot him now, yeah. First shot. Come on, get level. I'm off with the head. Drop the guts out. Job done. What we might do, let's put some onion, nice shallot on them. Put them in a baking tray, a bit of a gravy granules, and then simmer on the barbecue. A bit of tinfoil over top of it for when we cut them out, or we have a couple of beers.
I can even
smell the flavour. Smell the flavour, my boy, coming off that?
Yep.
That's proper cooking, my boy. That's what you got to learn to do, see? You got to learn to live in the wilderness, just in case we have to one day.
Why is it important to take your son out shooting?
Because he'll have the same morals now. He'll have the same respect for the land, for the people, for everything. And we eat for survival, yeah, I put that. Anyway.
How do you think younger children live their life these days who aren't in the gypsy community?
I feel sorry for them. Because some of them was behind closed doors. They haven't seen much of life. They just live in the same village, same street. They live the same life day in and day out. Our life's different. It's what it's all about, isn't it? It's what life's all about, isn't it? Outside, having a few beers, a bit of wild rabbit. Living free. Eh? You happy?
How you doing? Not very good. I went in and seen that fella who was supposed to be fighting me. And he's on about fight me with gloves on. You know, it's supposed to be like, you know what I mean, he's bare knuckle.
This man has talked about me. When other people has talked about me, he's kind of like, you know, kissed his lips, about me.
Listen, there's no fucking point talking about me, mate, to my fucking mate. Do you understand?
Alright then, yeah.
Do you understand that?
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
So you want to fucking get the fight on, you get it on. Fuck your gloves. You fight bare knuckle like you said you'd fight me. Do you understand?
Yeah, I understand what you're saying, alright.
I believe he said you got some beef with me. That was his word. I said, I believe I have. He said, we'll see. I said, okay. I said, let's do it. I said, I'll show you. I said, what a man is. I said, and we'll see who'll be sarcastic, which we will.
So someday...
We'll sort it out with these.
Exactly. We'll sort it out with these. Right?
All right.
And this will sort it out and all, believe me. I'll fucking cave your brain up here someday.
Like, now, a week Sunday, I can honestly, faithfully promise the whole world who's going to probably watch it, one day, I'll win. There's no doubt about it. I will win.
Up here, Daddy. Ain't down there anymore. Up here.
Where's your class?
It's up here.
What do you need?
I don't know.
Skinny. 2 quid enough?
2 quid. You just got out of lines. Are we doing the outside of it?
Yeah, we need to. And then
I can, all red. The teachers learn, tells us what to do, and we do it. When we try to do it better, what she says. What should we do now?
If you would like to put the lids on your paints for me, and somebody to choose to go wash the brushes for me.
I will. Oh, blood.
Yeah, there's blood in the sink. You're a really good artist, what you do. And I like the way you do it. He's really good at what he does, aren't you?
I don't know.
Do you like tanks?
Tanks?
Yeah.
What kind of tanks?
When did you leave school?
I can't remember now. The thing is, when I used to go to school, I was a fool for myself. I didn't really learn how to read or write. I should have put more time into learning. I was more busy in school fighting and messing about, to be honest with you, which is silly. But it was me and all my little mates, all the little travelling children and that. We were all the same, really. I don't think any of us learned how to read. For the children today, I don't know what it is, but they seem to be more focused on learning how to read.
How's it affected you not being able to read and write?
It's brought me the long way around some things in life. Do you know where? It's very, very awkward. You can be in a place and you can ask someone, do you know the way to such a place? Because you can't read, they'll say you're in it, mate. And they make you look like a proper fool.
Shall I read now?
Well, we'll read this page. What does it say at the top?
Isa is in a tap. Not sit it. It is in a pan.
Chris from Dorchester. I went out last night. Chinese water. Killed it with his dog here. He's a good running with about three dogs because these are fast.
Are you going to eat it?
Eat it, yeah. We're just going to skin it tonight. Get the blood out. Get the skin off it and put it on there. Your mum's going to cook it.
Have you ever hit someone in the face with that?
Lay it down.
No, John, lay down. I'm telling you, you're going to ruin me, John. Ah, you're ruining it, don't watch.
What's it done? It's done.
Put her straight up with her left. Bang her straight through that.
That's the sharpest knife I've ever seen in my life.
Sharpest knife, isn't
it? Sharp. Did you like chocolate like that, Charlie?
Yeah. Love one.
What for?
There's a few people I'd love to hit, but I bet that's happened before.
Your brother Charlie's a bit of a hothead. Now he's one of these men, if someone falls out of him, he wants to get it dealt with there and then and do it. You know, he's a bit hot-tempered. But obviously, maybe it's probably because he's young. He's one of these sort of men. No, he ain't too fussed. If a man asks him to fight, it's no problem.
When I walk into a pub and a travelling fella say, "What's your surname?" I say, "Doherty." You can look on his face, there's fear. He knows that if we do have a drink, he could never try say anything to me. Or you can see there's a look of frightening off him.
Look at his eyeball, John.
If my son was rearing up and I knew he couldn't fight, I'd definitely have a DNA test straight away, because I think, how could he be like this, you know what I mean? Like, I could fight. How could I breed a son to be like this, you know what I mean? And that's why we like loads of sons. That's why we make our business have loads of kids for us. Because at the end of the day, if you get into an argument, you have to have a good few sons with you, because you know you'll have five good men to fight. If you do have an argument, you've got backup there. You've got your sons.
He said, "Boy, you might not understand, but a long, long time ago, Grandma's daddy didn't like me much, but I loved your grandma so.
Go on, Sean.
We had this crazy plan to meet and run away.
Pretty strong boys. All the boys.
Get married in the first town we came to and live forever. Nailed to the tree where I was supposed to be instead. I read this letter and this is what it says. If you get there before I do, don't give up on me.
Pretty much.
Yep. I'll meet you in my chosen room. I don't know how long I'll be.
All the boys. All the boys.
But I'm not going to let you down. And darling, wait and see.
Yep.
And between now and then, till I see you again, I'll be loving you. Love me.
You only get a good dog by giving him a good food, boys. This is the part of the ingredient. You want a good one.
The Bible says in John 3:16, "For God so loved the world, he gave his only son. He died for everybody. We're all sinners. And without Jesus, we'll never get to heaven." But the Bible says there is none righteous, not even one. So all he has to do is repent of his sins.
Have you tried to get Fred to...
Yeah, I brought him to a Christian meeting many of years ago in Chippy Norton. When he was a bit younger, he was a bit wilder. He's calmed down a lot from then. I took him to a church and the man was preaching the gospel. and he didn't like it, and he was going to kill the pastor in the church, and I felt very embarrassed at what he'd done.
He never took me to a number one since.
You hear of many people say, I'm the king of the gypsies, I'm the king of the gypsies, I'm the best fighter, I've got the best dog, I've got the best chicken. You hear of all this. But many a man has made yourself fighting men amongst gypsies only by their mouth and by other people saying so. But there's people that I know that's made yourself men of fighting men because they've proved it. And I've seen Fred have a good few fights in his time, and he can have a bit of an old scrap. I wouldn't say he's no Muhammad Ali, but he can have a scrap. So, but I don't think there's any honour in it, no. I don't know. All I know is the Bible says unless a man's born again, he won't even see heaven. Never mind getting it.
Heaven doesn't want me and hell's afraid I'll take over. So where am I going to go to? I don't know.
Hello!
What's
up? Don't touch the point.
No.
That's looking good, isn't it?
Yeah.
The last time I seen him, the whiskers was all in, he wasn't quite finished. Now obviously the whiskers and that's out and the chest is done.
I'd like to hear you, Daddy.
Mm-hmm. It's just like the bitch when she was alive. I think it's just unbelievable the work these taxidermists can do to do that. She's just an unbelievable bitch. Believe me and you, she was. That's her name, Molly, undefeated legend, from 2000 to 2004. And after every match, I used to bring her home. I used to probably give her some steak, and I used to then run a bath. There was nice hot water and some Radox in it, and I used to soak her for 1 hour. Then she used to get out of the bath, dry her with a towel, put an old hair dryer thing on her to dry her up, and that's when she'd have her food after she'd have her bath.
But how did she die?
She got run over. There was a man who used to look after her for me. He used to walk her every day for me. And a white transit van kept passing up and down. It ran over the dog, well, the bitch, Molly, and the man who was walking the bitch. But the man in hospital broke all his bones and killed the bitch. But in a way, it was lucky that it worked out like that rather than the other way around. But the man was okay. After a few weeks in the hospital. He was in there for about 3 weeks, I think. Obviously, I went up to the hospital to see him, and the poor old fellow was laid in the bed, and he was more frightened of what I was probably going to say to him over the bitch, because he knew how much he loved that bitch. And he started saying, I'm sorry, and somebody could hardly speak over his ribs, and that it was all broke. So I said, just don't be stupid. I said, I'm just pleased to see that it was a dog instead of you, obviously. But obviously I'd missed my old bitch as well. It was bad to see my old bitch get run over. I loved the old bitch.
God, quite good up here, isn't it? Okay. God, lovely view. Push, push, push. Push, push. Push, push, push. Push, push, push.
Come on, come on, come on. Yeah, come on. Yeah, come on. Yeah, come on. Hands up. I just got a phone call there. And no, one fella's not, another fella's supposed to be fighting them. He's not coming here in the morning. There's a different man fighting me in the morning, which is his brother. Yeah, and I have never met his brother.
They're trying to trick you now, if you know what I mean.
Could be as well.
Send it different in Poland, so you're like, that's to mess your plans up you had for the other fella.
Yeah, exactly.
But it doesn't really make a difference, does it?
No, I don't care.
So everything's changed for tomorrow, last minute. How do you adjust as a fighter?
At the end of the day, mate, up or down, whoever I fight, it's going to be just a fighter, isn't it? So I'll just have to turn up in the morning, fight who's ever there. Whoever he brings to fight me, I'll just fight him, and that's it. Although, to be quite honest with you, I don't really care who he brings. Just as long as he brings someone to solve the matter and put an end to it.
best man in the world, I know that.
I'm not the best man in the world.
You are the best man in the world.
I wouldn't say that.
You are, though.
You shouldn't say that. And I wouldn't say that because I wouldn't insult no one. I'm not the best man in the world, probably. But I know one thing, I'll fight any man in the world. Any man asks me to fight, he's got to fight. I wasn't ready for this man today. But I'm going to make myself ready for him. Simple as that.
He's never fought a man like you yet.
Fight him, I want to just take him apart. All the respect in the world to him. He's a man that he's gone out there and he's having his fucking go, you know what I mean? He's fighting. He's doing his job. He's never fought a man like me in his life. Never in his life. I have to be ready to fight until I die. Until I win. You know, it's die or win with me, and that's it.
Yep.
Shots. Shots.
Carp, finish carp.
Good shot! Good shot! That's Dorothy for you!
Get back!
Fucking best man in the world!
Stand back,
sir.
Get back!
We had a fucking bet!
Get back! Have you had enough,
mate,
of your
beat? Not
away?
Very, mate.
Will that be you?
Yeah.
You know, my brother's the best, better man than me, and I don't get him to fight anyone for me.
All right, yeah.
Shake hands, Johnny. It was a good, clean fight, boss. Man, it's a proper fight, Johnny.
Eh?
He's rare, right?
Fucking
it. Oh, I'll tell you what that's about there.
Is it a black kid?
Listen,
fair play to
you, mate. Listen, you're a game man, and that's the problem solved. You come today to sort it out, and that's the job done, right?
Yeah, no worries, mate.
End of story. So you go clean punch, lads. It's worth 50 fucking... rough ones, didn't they, John? When you carry on clean, that was clean, wasn't it? You heard a flump. He was the biggest man I ever seen. As a matter of fact, I think he's one of the biggest human beings I ever seen.
He's got a good shot, though.
Big, innit? They're not troublesome people. They don't get into trouble. They don't go around looking for us. So the ones that they do give a hiding to deserves it. You know what I mean? So you shouldn't pick on people that they can't handle.
Boys, he's a big man.
He's a big fella.
He had me weighed up there, that's why I danced away. I saw him. I copped him on having me weighed, so I thought I'm going to move now.
He's a big man,
Q. Q has always been his own sort of little geezer, you know what I mean? All his life growing up. Q was always a man child. He was never a child, he was always a man.
Is your dad a good fighter? What do you think?
He's a good fighter.
Are you proud of him?
Yeah.
They all follow suit. I mean, it's not pressure on them. Because it's born in them, so when they're born like that, it's in their blood, they don't turn out no different.
Good shot! Oh. Good shot!
Good shot, Kim.
That's Dorothy for you, Mark! That's my
fucking best man ever! Not a bother. No cases. Oh, another one bites the dust.
Fights don't finish and start on one day. After a fight, that fight could be, if it's a good fight, it could be talked about for 10 years or 20 years. I've heard stories about fights that go back generations. My great-grandfather fought on Ballaslow Fair, and he fought one of the Gormans, Bartley Gormans, King of the Gypsies. That fight was 1952, and they fought for 2 hours and 20 minutes. My grandfather had his hand taken off afterwards because he punched so much, he smashed all the ligaments in his hand. He had his hand amputated. Well, then he put a hook on his hand after the fight, and he was very dangerous to that. So the police made him take that off, and he had to have a bit of wood put on there at the end. But that was that fight gets talked about today.
What was he like growing up?
He's a good boy.
Just when he got his teenager, went off the rails a bit. Started boxing and training.
He got in with the wrong company. At the wrong age. 15.
That's when he started fighting and got more aggressive.
If you upset Fred and you disciplined him, he'd just scream and go mad, but his dad could always calm him down.
My dad ruled him with a strong hand, though.
Yeah, he did.
He
did.
He knew my dad meant it. He knew when he was playing and he knew when he meant it. And he did listen to my dad.
Right up until his father died, Fred was always the type of fella that you could always rely on. He was close to his dad.
So what age was he when he lost his father?
25.
Mm. How did that affect him?
Terrible. I don't think Fred's still got over it today, losing his dad. He's still sitting here sometimes when me and him's talking and he'll have a cry over it.
When I lost my dad, I went completely off the rails for a long time. Fights got more, like you say, more aggression, more evil. And when you do it, you worry afterwards, I hope I've not killed that person. I hope I'm not eating too hard and giving brain damage. I hope that man can go home and see his children, or I can see my kids.
If you were to lose, how would that make you feel?
I don't know. If I lost the fight, I wouldn't know how I felt. It'd destroy me. I couldn't cope with it. I couldn't cope with it. I cope with a lot of stuff in my life. If I got beat, I don't know how I'll cope with that. I just don't know how I'll cope with it. Air Blue Neil. Sun was shining. It was a perfect day for it. Travellers and drink does not mix well. Things happen. The next thing I know, his dad, his brothers, his family, his sisters, I don't know who was there, and his cousins. They was kicking me up on the site, up and down the floor. I got kicked in the face. It was a no-win situation. But I managed to get off that site alive.
My mum died of cancer, same as my father. I'm kidding.
I'll kill him, man.
Well, do it right. Don't
I'll kill his two sons, and I'll kill you.
Don't do it tonight, Fred. You can't do it.
Tonight?
You can't do it tonight. Oh,
I'm going to fight for that. I'm going to have a fair play fight. I'm going to bust him.
Goodbye.
I'm going to bust your man. Break your man. Stamp on his head for me, please. Please, stand my head. He told me to cut my throat.
Now listen, I don't want to see you hurting anyway. I want to see you do it right. All right, Fred? Do it right, my boy.
I'll do it right. I'm right.
You've been kicked from pillar to post.
No, that's nothing.
Be sensible about it.
Listen, that's nothing. My dad's great. It's nothing. I want to go back.
You can't
fight.
See out of that eye, can you?
No, that's great. That's nothing.
You can't see out of it, can you?
I can see out of the eye. The eye's nothing. I want to go back there. So if the boy is here, I'm going to fight him.
So I had a couple of hours sober up with a couple of cups of coffee. I was ready to fight. I wanted revenge. I said, come out and have a fight. Come out and fight me now, I'm sober. The next thing I know, I had swords and machetes coming just sweeping towards me. I didn't know where that was coming from, left or right, I didn't know what happened. Just shoo, and you could hear it, shoo, I'd seen the flashes of the blades. Didn't know, there was a lot going through my mind when the sword was coming past it, but I just thought I'm dead. I thought, this is it. And the next thing I know, I got hit from behind, with one across the top of the head. I went down on one knee, and I bounced back up again. As soon as I got back up, it happened again. But that time I realised there wasn't no punch, it was a machete going into my head. And I felt blood running down my face. The most frightening part about it was, after the fight was over, I had to walk back past two guys who cut me up. One had a baseball bat, and the other had a machete, and they were swinging them towards me. It was coming from my face. I moved my head to the side, and it caught me across the shoulder. And his ear hit me, and the baseball bat hit me at the same time. When the machete went into the muscle, I felt my shoulder drop. I felt it just cut all the muscle. And I could hear it actually go and chunk into the bone. And I knowed I was hurting. If it had been a bit harder, it would have cut right through the bone. It would have cut my arm off, but I was lucky.
I didn't recognise him when I first went in. I was just hysterical. I really did think, is Fred going to be all right? Is he going to be out of his mind or what? Because I'll be honest, and I really do mean it from the bottom of my heart, if I'd have seen any of them that day and I'd have had a weapon, I would have used it. I would have done to them what they'd done to my son. Because I've lived my life, I've had a good life. And to see this, the way they served my son, I would have killed one of
them. In a matter of a couple of days, I was stitched up on the phone, trying to organise a fight with the same people to come back and fight me again. Come out of hospital, and I was a bit still on drugs like morphine, and just took a good hard look at what was going on around me. I knew I had to get better. I knew I had to get better quick. You got to reflect on things, like I said. It ain't just about getting cut up, it's about emotionally as well. You've got to get your head around it. Just rested up, spent time with my kids. Peaceful. Back home, back in the land, and just thinking and just got myself, got my dog, walked my dogs a few miles across the fields on my own. Peaceful.
spending time on your own is a good thing. It's a good meditation. If you want to get over things like that, it just gives you time to reflect on it without anyone else's opinion. Get your head around it.
I love him a lot. I don't like him fighting. It's really bad for him. If he, fights, it get bad and he might die. My dad had 300 stitches and I never really liked that. And it was very crazy and I really never liked it.
He won't move on from what they've done. He will never, ever. He still thinks about that all the time. Sometimes he just drifts off. And I said, what do you think about, Fred? And he said, I'm just thinking about, you know what I'm thinking about. And he don't talk about it in front of Freddie Cole or Cash. He won't talk about it, but he could never forget that. And it always comes up.
The people who cut me up, I'll never forget that. I'll never, ever forget it. And one day, I will have a chance to give him the best hiding he'll ever have. Because there'll be no mercy. Enough for it, there'll be no mercy. No one will be able to stop it. So when I get my hands on him, I'll beat him like a baby. And I'll win.
Fast ride though.
Never ever going on that again.
Spinning.
Fucking rubbish. This one's mine.
So they've just been born?
Yeah, a few days ago. This one's is mine. This one is. It's out of my hen cup. And that cockerel up there, this one is. And the wings, they're already grown. They've gone weed coloured.
Where did they come from?
They come from an egg. From them.
I'm gonna shoot this old bird. Look at him, man. Ah. Take him out of his misery. Sent it out them down, but it's got a little more tight. Stand
still. Come over the hedge.
Send it over.
Ah, the blood off the plot, man!
Meeting the shed down, that you call fun? That's fucking stupid, isn't it? You ain't meant to, are you? Or was it worth crying over? If I'm crying for any goals, I would give you something to cry for. Like he cries, you'd have to beat me wrong and then give me something to cry for. When I'm crying for nothing, you need to give me something to cry for.
And what did he used to do?
Punch me head right in. If I see me crying, if I come back and fall off my bike for crying and cut all my leg open, say, here's what you're crying for. I was supposed to cut my leg and he'd give me another item for crying. That's what my dad is doing to me. What different way I treat you?
Bobby Butcher, the legend. Often as I can, if everyone passes by, I pop in for 10 minutes. Have a chat with him. He was one man in my life I can honestly say I was frightened of. Because he used to put me in my place. And he was the only man who ever did. It's my life. He was my life. And I was his life. I loved him dearly.
Yeah, a little baby boy. He's come. I got 13 weeks left. Can't wait. And he's on the scan photos. He's got his hands up already. He's a lot like his dad, like, you know. Every scan photo we go to, like, he's always got his hands like that. We've got 15 scan pictures, and in the 15 scan pictures, his two hands is like that. But I was the same. I was, well, obviously stupid, but I was born with a black eye, and I was born with my hands up as well. And so hopefully, it's so far so good. I can't wait to be having though. I'm calling after my dad, Francis.
Yeah.
He's not even born yet and he wants to fight.
You can tell from no age when the little boy's 7, 8 years old and you see him fighting another little boy that can fight. And you see the other little boy hitting him and hurting him even. You can see the expression on his face, he's been hurt, but he still won't jack.
Striding, come on! Faster!
Sometimes faster. It's hard to see a little boy getting hit hard if he's fighting a little boy a little bit too good for him even. But, you know, sometimes you've got to stand and watch. And let's see what he's like under pressure.
Come on, keep going! Faster, come on!
We're having a spar, but...
What's sparring?
Sparring means pretend fighting.
Sparring is a different thing about fighting. Because when you're fighting, you get to do counter punches and hard punches. But in sparring, you're saying like little kick soft. Sparring. Yeah, soft.
So sparring is like practice.
Yeah.
So you like practice.
Yeah.
You're born with it. My son is now born with it, and I know he is. He's born with it. I know you're like me, and I know you won't let anybody off for making a fool out of you, or pulling you, or insulting you, or making you look small, or downgrade you. You would rather die. You will fight until a bitter end, and I know you will. My son, I seen him. He's only 7 years old, and I seen him spar by 2 stone heavier. You know, really good fighter. Hit my little boy a punch and his head hit the concrete first and he got up with a lump on his forehead. And kept going and sparred on for about a 35-minute spar. And as a matter of fact, for 2 children, it was the best spar I ever seen. And the words he said to me afterwards, he said, "Daddy, I'm a Doherty, and I'll do whatever it takes to win." You've done well, because you're about 2 stone heavier than my friend.
Yeah, we did have a bat.
You look at him and you see, like, you see yourself in him. You see your father in him. You see your uncles in him. You think to yourself, yeah, you're one of us. You're gonna want to fight. So I'm going to have to teach you to fight right, because I know if you lost, it'll wreck your life. I thought, to fucking hell, it's just a strong belief, you know, it's a disease that's passed on. Mission completed. You know, he's there, he's got it. I know he has. Even if a man was too good for him in a fight, he'd never jack. He'd just keep going, 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 and going, and going, and going. He'd never stop.
I don't want to go back to prison. I don't want to go back to prison and leave my children. They're my life. My wife's my life. My mum, sisters, my brothers. I'm here for a responsibility to look after them on the outside. I'm here to protect them. But I would be prepared to go to prison for the man who cut me up.
You'd be willing to give up your children for vengeance?
For revenge, I'd give up anything. Anything.
My name is Freddie Cole Butcher. I am 9 years old. And I'm a gypsy.
And what do you want to be when you grow up?
A fighter.